kids within these channel favorites here. Yeah, so for example, I need to put it in the channel that we are because it's specifically a favorite to use for me.
Thank you. Thank you.
do with their crossover, the small team, Well, that was, yeah, I mean, like, if you wanted to have actual points, then certainly you would have to have a conversation with us about how we're going to implement 25 things that we're going to say. So this is just telling us where we are with this. What are you looking to do from here for each project? If you look to the development plan, I want something fixed that has a project. So we have a link for the development files, and depending on what it is, for example, if it's going to be something that's going to be in GitLab, for whatever reason, then you link to GitLab. If it's something that's in a Microsoft project file, then we link to that project file. If it's in a spreadsheet, we link to the spreadsheet, or we link to the folder, or the channel, or whatever we're using to say what it is. But basically, this is just a summary of where we're at. As far as I know, the thing is that we're not at the moment for ICT Basic, for example. We've not actually built in any of the development to this particular class. No, that's a kind of whereas we are having lots of conversations around it. I mean, one of the problems of using lists is you can fix it, and you can create different views. So you can set it up in such a way that if we have a meeting of all such action points, then we set a flag on it, and it will appear in the view, to review action points for this meeting, for example. And then we can just go through, when someone's got something they want to go into the master community meeting, they set a flag on it, and then we just pull it up in the meeting and we go through it. So this. The answer to that is yes and probably. So at the moment we are experimenting with a project tracker, which is looking at each of the live and active projects we've got and what they're related to, and to see if we can use this in some way for each project. If we're looking at something where we're focusing on purely on each action point, are we talking about it being an action point for a specific meeting, or is that an action point as in the next action that needs to be taken within the platform team that is assigned to somebody? There's okay, so this is an area which is under discussion at the moment. We established tools in here. You can do it for Microsoft Planner. OneNote, Microsoft Planner, Outlook, and To-Do are all being brought together into the same application. So if I were to look in my Outlook, there's a task section in Outlook. That also is actually pages in the To-Do. So for example, here are a listing of the main projects that I'm working on, the main areas. Here are the supporting projects that relate to those. If it appears in a Microsoft Planner area, then it's something that's been assigned to me, which appears up here. If it was put in through Outlook automatically, or I just created it over here to task with related to a specific project, then it appears up here in tasks. So this is an app which does that, but if I wanted to find out where the origin of the Yep. perfect opportunity, not obviously not right now, but so this is what this is all of the main strategic railway development poles built into this is what the landscape is. Well, the thing is, So the project that we've been involved with over time is a bit more of a position now, but This is exactly one of the major projects that I'm working on, which is Take Back Your Time, which is effectively one of the test groups for the other is the Man Sales team, the other is the Penalty, and also PR and MMEA, which is another project that we're working on now, on how to structure these sorts of applications and how to communicate the processes that we're doing around work-life balance and the labour. Thanks everybody. Lots more discussion on this. Nothing sort of set in stone. But let's look and see how we develop it from here.
Hi, Doc.
See you later. Yeah, sorry, I had to run. You've had some fun with learning what this was actually. So, that's okay. I think there's a bunch of stuff that's really completed. And they can also see what the most popular activities are. If you wanted the completions for each one of these activities, just pulling back the recording to see an overview. But if you want to be able to extract stuff, then we're going to extract stuff from here once we've saved the query together. So I'm going to go into, there we go, the 184 statements in the presentation, in the current installation MMEA. Yeah, it's 193 different records that we've got. So where we want to actually, so like if I wanted to, I could potentially download it. I could see that as a new query, and we should download that as a new query. I don't really want to see 193 different statements. I'm going to have a quick check and see what my options are. So you could look at something specific that you wanted to see, what you've been done to, what are your abilities, AI, and machine learning.